Hello, I'm Michael Fine. We're coming to you today from Zebra's RFID laboratory, and I want to do a quick demonstration of the RXi4's ability to automatically calibrate for unpitched media. I'm going to walk you through that process, exactly how it works, and we're going to show you doing that on two different tag types. One that I have loaded now is the brand new belt from RaffleTech. This uses NXP's latest chip, the G2IL. And the other tag that I'm going to show you that I have in my hand here is Alien's latest tag. This is called the Squiglet and uses their Higgs 3 chip. So I have this tag loaded already, and the first thing I need to do is calibrate for the label length. Just like any other, you know, standard media with RFID media, we have to calibrate the label length so the printer knows how long the label is. And I do that by just pressing this little calibrate button right in the front of the printer. So I'm going to press this button. The printer feeds a few labels and automatically calibrates that label. So now the printer knows how long each tag is. And the next step is I need to do the RFID calibrate. And it's important to realize that's different than just the label length calibrate. The RFID calibrate procedure actually sets commands, actually sets parameters like RFID encode power and like the RFID element settings that are required to encode this from our adaptive array technology. So what I need to do there is remove one label. I need to remove the label so the printer doesn't get confused and accidentally encode on a forward tag. I want it to calibrate on the tag underneath the print head. And then I initiate the RFID calibrate procedure from the front panel of the printer. I go into the menu and I scroll to the left over to the command that says RFID tag calibrate. And I just press the run button. And as I press this, the printer backfeeds the label into the printer. It's stepping in 1 millimeter steps backward. And throughout that process, it's actually scanning through each of the individual elements in the encoding array. This is actually the patent pending Zebra encoding array that's inside this printer. And this is really what provides us the flexibility to encode these inlays and to automatically do this calibration procedure. It's inside this encoding array. So you see the printer stepping through. It's finished calibrating and we're ready to go. So I don't like to waste RFID labels. So what I'm going to do is replace this tag back on the roll. Let's rewind this back into the printer. And now we're ready to print. So I have a label format, just a simple label format preloaded on my computer. I'm going to go ahead and send that to the printer, and I'm going to send five tags. And there's the result. So we encoded five tags sequentially, RaffleTech G2IL belts, brand new tag. So great demonstration. But next step is, how difficult is that to switch to a different type of media if I need to? Maybe I need to tag a different item, or maybe I had problems getting that particular tag and I need to change. This is one of the real advantages of the adaptive encoding array. So I need to change media types. So I'm gonna go ahead and load the new Squiglet from Alien. And same procedure we went through before. First thing I need to do is calibrate that label length, because this is actually a little bit shorter label than the RaffleTech tag I just printed. So I do that by pressing the calibrate button. And then next I need to run the RFID calibrate button. And that command's already up on the front panel, so I don't need to scroll over to it again. I can just initiate it right here. And you see the same procedure as before, as the printer stepping back into the printer, or the media stepping back into the printer, calibrating that label, identifying the proper one of these elements to encode that tag in the most efficient way possible. And you see it's complete. And again, I don't really like to label that many media. I'm going to roll that back into the printer. Close the printer, and then I'm actually going to send the exact same label format that I sent before. I made no changes to this whatsoever, because the printer controls all the RFID settings. I don't need to have that in my format. And there's the exact same label format, the exact same data encoded to the Squiglet that we encoded to the G2IL belt. So great flexibility, and that really shows the power of our adaptive array and the flexibility of the printer, not only for what media is available today, but the media that's available tomorrow as well.